this asl, ayyuhal ikhwa, that when we observe and we read those ahadith related to the ruler, that we, the Messenger of Allah, to the extent, ikhwan, that at his, that sermon, ikhwan, that the sahaba, they felt was a going away sermon. As occurs in the hadith of Irbad ibn Isariya, that we heard the Messenger of Allah give us a sermon, ظرفت منها العيون ووجلت منها القلوب, that the hearts tremored because of it and the eyes shed tears. When we say, O Messenger of Allah, it is as though this is a going away sermon, so advise us. And so he said, أوسيكم بتقوى الله والسمع والطاعة. I advise you with the fear of Allah and to hear and obey. To hear and obey. And that, ikhwan, is the first thing that the Messenger of Allah was concentrated upon and was concerned with after reminding them of the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal, taqwallah. The first thing he mentioned after taqwa, hear and obey. And this stress that we have upon hearing and obeying the ruler and being united upon the ruler is not, ikhwan, as those who are affected greatly by conspiracy theorists that these are ahadith that were incorporated into Bukhari and the Messenger actually didn't say it, mention them. Or ahadith that were incorporated into Muslim by those who want us to be, yani, under the thumb of the ruler. These rulers that are puppets of the government and so on and so forth, and those scholars who serve them and service their opinion. La, ikhwan. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made that statement, and it is present in the kitab and in the sunnah and in the statements of the salaf of this ummah. And we need to be aware of these conspiracy theorists, ikhwan. Wallahi. And we need to be aware of spending the amount of time that some of you brothers spend upon this study of conspiracy theory and the conspiracy ideas and Illuminati and the various videos and all of these YouTube links that link into another. And that one clicks through and sits for hours. And you may conclude that it does sound true though. And so now you look at everyone with the eye of Illuminati. Apparently, Juan, I can't remember where it was, whether we traveled to Canada or somewhere. We had a sitting with some brothers. And we were sitting over food. And he said, one of the brothers said, Yaki, you know, Abu Hakim, Jazakallah Khair, please don't be offended by what I'm about to say. But we had a discussion with some brothers and some brothers were mentioning some issues yourself, yani, you and Abu Khadija, you know, you came into the topic. And you know, the brother was saying some things. I said, Khair, inshallah. I said, I forgive him before and after. Before and after, before I even know what it is, he said, forgive him. He said, no, but you know, he made some accusations and he was saying some things, you know. He said that, he said, Yaki, that he believes that you're with the Illuminati. Ikhwan, I couldn't stop giggling. I said, mashallah, khair. I said, on what basis? He said, because the last time you were in Canada, when you were given a lecture, that while you were giving the lecture and you were getting heated in the lecture, that you raised your hand and you were doing this. That you were doing this with your hand. And he said that this is from the symbols of the Illuminati, you know, these hand symbols that they do, and it represents affiliation to the brotherhood and to the fraternity. So I was apparently given a lecture and I also did some movements with my finger. Huh? Subhanallah al-Azim. If that is the case, ikhwan, subhanallah, then you would believe, some would believe I'm a blood or a crip likewise then on the basis of hand movements. But to this extent, anyway, ikhwan, I didn't know whether to laugh or cry. Illuminati, because I did this with my hand. And that is the extent, ikhwan, that the study of these conspiracy theories will have individuals, taking individuals away, ayyuhal ikhwah, from the study of that which will protect us from any conspiracy. And that is the study of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, drawing closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remaining with the jama'ah. When we're speaking about the jama'ah, ayyuhal ikhwa, no doubt we're speaking about those who are at the head of the jama'ah. And those who are at the head of the jama'ah, ikhwan, they are the ulama of this ummah, the ulama of Ahlul Sunnah. And in every era, in every time, it is of the essence that we affiliate ourselves and that we're well acquainted with the ulama of Ahlul Sunnah in our time and those who are at the head of the jama'ah.